All right, well, here we are in Lightroom, and I have a bunch of images here that I shot with the X-T4 and the X-T5. Now, these are all raw files that are not edited at all, except for some white balance adjustments. So other than that, the images are untouched. But before we get into these more real world shots, I just wanna go over some of these test chart shots that I captured. This way, it kinda gives us a more controlled scenario to examine the images. So we'll go over some of these shots here, and then after that, we'll go back to these more real world shots. So these test chart images are all shot at different ISO values so that we can compare the ISO performance of the X-T5 versus the X-T4. But before we compare the two cameras, let's go ahead and we'll just take a quick look at just the X-T5 for a second. And just so you know, the settings that I use for all these test chart shots here, I essentially just kept the shutter speed in automatic mode, the aperture at f8, and then I adjusted the ISO value between each shot. And the lens that I used was the 16-55mm f2.8. All right, so anyways, let's go ahead, jump in here. We'll compare ISO 125 on the left and ISO 200 on the right. So both of these are X-T5 shots. And we're just gonna zoom in here and kind of do side by side. And there's really not much of a difference at all. Maybe slightly grainier on the ISO 200, but it is pretty much a negligible difference here. And I'm not gonna spend too much time there. ISO 200, we'll just kind of keep moving up the range. So now on the left, we have ISO 125. On the right, we have ISO 400. Let's go ahead, zoom in. And again, ISO 400 is not much difference. It looks super, super clean. Maybe a slight bit of grain, but it is very clean, very usable at ISO 400. Let's move up to 800. So we got 125 on the left, ISO 800 on the right. Zoom in here. And now we're starting to see a little bit more grain, so it's a little bit more noticeable now at ISO 800. Move over to this side as well. But it's still, I would say ISO 800 is still super, super clean as well. So get some of these shades up here. It's really hard to tell a difference. 800 is looking very good. All right, let's move up. We'll compare 125 versus ISO 1600. So 1600's on the left. I'm sorry, on the right. 125 on the left. All right. So now we're seeing a more noticeable difference for sure. So there's definitely some grain here. Look at this purple color. Definitely a more grain here on the right versus the left. Same thing kind of throughout the whole image here. But it's still, I would say, super usable. It's not like so much noise where it destroys the image or anything. It's still a very usable shot. So that's good. 1600 is looking pretty good. All right, let's move up to 3200. All right, so 3200 on the right here. And now you can see a much bigger difference. For ISO 3200, I wouldn't say it's unusable, but it's definitely starting to get closer to that point. All right, let's move on. 6400 here. Okay, so now it's ISO 6400. Definitely seeing a lot of noise here. For sure. All over, everywhere, everywhere. The white, the kind of the gray, all these colors. So pretty much the entire image is noisy. I don't know if I'd want to use ISO 6400 on this camera unless I absolutely had to. All right, let's go ahead. We'll move on to the 12,800 shot. And as expected, very, very noisy here. Wouldn't want to use this. All right, so let's go ahead. We'll look at some comparison shots between the X-T4 now and the X-T5. And we'll see how those do. And so we'll just do a quick base ISO shot. So we'll do the X-T4 on the left here. Its base ISO is 160. And we have the X-T5 on the right at ISO 125 as its base. And we zoom in here. Let's go ahead and sync that up more. Well, I didn't get these perfectly, the shot perfectly identical here. But one thing you can see here is the resolution difference. So there's a 14 megapixel difference between these two cameras. So the X-T5 has 40 megapixels, the X-T4 has 26. And you can kind of see that difference here as you look through the shot. But anyways, as far as the ISO is concerned, they both look super clean at the base ISO as expected. Let's go ahead and we'll jump up a few levels here and let's look at ISO 1600. All right, so we got the X-T4 on the left, X-T5 on the right, ISO 1600. And I would say this is close. So I don't really notice a big difference between the two. I would say the noise level is pretty even here. I'm not seeing a huge difference there. All right, so let's go ahead and compare ISO 3200, see if there's a difference there. And I'd say maybe there's a little bit more noise in the X-T5, but you know, it is a higher resolution camera, so even the noise is going to come in at a higher resolution as well. But what I have done is I downsampled an X-T5 image to the X-T4 image size, so that 26 megapixels. So let's look at a downsampled 3200 ISO 3200 image. So X-T5 on the right, X-T4 on the left again. So yeah, honestly, I'd say that these are pretty neck and neck. There's not a huge difference at all when downsampled. Really hard to find a difference here. So that's pretty cool. So to me, this looks like the X-T5 is performing right neck and neck with the X-T4, which is awesome because it's obviously a higher resolution camera. So let's go ahead, we'll look at 6400, ISO 6400. All right. Again, it's not a huge difference here. So I'm gonna look at the downsampled one again. We'll see what that looks like here. Again, X-T4 on the left, X-T5 downsampled on the right. And yeah, it's really, really close here. Not a huge difference at all. It's hard to even say if one is better than the other. Look at some of these darker colors. You know, there may be a slight bit more noise in the X-T5 file here, but it is really close. And actually over here, to me, this red, looks like there's more noise actually in the X-T4 file. So I don't know, I would say these two are pretty close. And let's go ahead and look at ISO 12,800 and we'll go straight to the X-T5 downsampled image. Take a look here. And again, they're pretty close. Really hard to say if one is better than the other here. I mean, this is an ISO that I generally would never use, but yeah, they're pretty neck and neck. So the other thing I have here with these test chart shots, I have a couple of underexposed shots here. Now this one is with the X-T5 and it's underexposed by 3 stops. So what I'm gonna do is just boost the exposure by 3 stops like that. And so this was shot at ISO 125, the base ISO. And then what I'm gonna do here is we'll just copy that real quick, paste it into this file. So this is the X-T4 base ISO shot. This was also underexposed by 3 stops. And it looks like the white balance is a little bit off. Let's do something like that. Okay, and what we can do here is just compare these 2 shots now. So again, these are base ISO. We have the X-T4 ISO 160 on the left, X-T5 ISO 125 on the right. So these are boosted by 3 stops. Let's let that load. And we can see that there's not a whole lot of difference between these two. Look at some of these colors. Just not a whole lot of difference there. And what I have also done is downsampled one of these. So downsampled that X-T5 shot down to the X-T4 resolution. And you can take a look. So this is actually, I would say the X-T5 looks maybe slightly cleaner. It's really hard to say though. But either way, it's performing very well. All right, so I hope that's helpful. Let's go ahead and we'll move up to some of these kind of more real world shots here. So this first shot we'll take a look at is this waterfall image here. And I'll go ahead and pull up the X-T4 on the left, X-T5 on the right. So this X-T4 shot here was 1.5 second exposure, F11, ISO 160. And the X-T5 shot was a 2 second exposure, F11, ISO 125. And let's go ahead and zoom into 100% here. Right away, you can see that extra resolution of the X-T5 file here. And let's kind of poke around here in the image. Everything's looking good. And you know, there's not a whole lot of difference between the two files, which I think is a good thing because the X-T4 was already a great camera that had really good image quality. And you know, one thing I want to do here is take this shot here and let's boost the shadows up a little bit so we can see things a little better there. And we'll do the same thing here. Just boost this up, something like that. Now let's go ahead and compare these again. X-T4 on the left, X-T5 on the right, and let it load. Okay. Now we can see things a little bit more clearly here. And you can see there's really not a huge difference aside from the resolution difference. As we poke around the image. But yeah. Now, if we look here, these shots here are basically just the same exact shot, except underexposed. And what I'll do here is boost this up by about 3 stops for this one. I'm also gonna boost up those shadows again, go up to 80 there. And we'll do the same thing here. Boost this up by 3 stops. And we'll go up to about 80 there, close enough. So compare these side by side. And we have the, again, X-T4 on the left, X-T5 on the right. Gonna zoom in here. Now there does look to be a little bit of a white balance difference here. But as far as the noise, I'm definitely seeing more noise here on the X-T5. But I'm not sure if that's just because I can see it more clearly because it's a higher resolution image. And like we looked at, when we looked at those test chart shots, the noise looks almost identical, and then especially when you downsampled. But overall, I'd say, you know, these files have a good amount of leeway. I mean, I pushed this pretty hard. And these other shots here, these are even more underexposed. So this one is more like five stops. And these, we'll boost this up like that. And we'll do this one about the same here. Now, I would never really push files this hard in the real world, but just for testing purposes, you know, we're gonna do that. And we're just gonna see a noisy mess here in both of the images. Just a whole lot of noise. So there is obviously a point where you're pushing things a little bit too far with any camera. So anyways, let's go ahead. We'll move on to some of these next series of images here. Now these are all shot at different ISO values, kind of similar to those test chart images. But what I'd like to do, I'm not going to go through every single ISO value, but we will look at, start at like 1600 here. And again, XT4 on the left, XT5 on the right. So these are shot at 1600 ISO. And we'll take a look here. And there's really no difference that I can really discern here. It is very, very close. And I'm gonna boost the shadows here just slightly. Bring it up to something like that. And then let's do the same thing here. Bring this up a little bit. All right, and then let's compare these. All right, this will be able to see things a little bit better here. Okay, now I'm just kind of looking at, let's pull this out, kind of looking at this area here and this area here. And again, there's really not a huge difference. I feel like I can see slightly more noise, but again, that's probably the resolution difference here. But they are very, very, very close, which is great news that the XT5 is performing this well. All right. Now let's go ahead and we'll look at ISO 3200 here. Again, very similar noise pattern here, similar noise performance. We're not gonna do the shadow boost on all of these. I just wanna go through some more. This is ISO 6400. Again, the XT4 is on the left, XT5 on the right. Let it load, all right. And again, a very, very similar noise performance. Kind of looking at this area, even in the snow. So yeah, there's not a huge difference here. And just for kicks, let's go ahead and look at the 12,800 image here. Let's go ahead and look at this. All right, this is a noisy mess, as expected. So let's go ahead now and move on to some other shots. Now, this shot here is just another waterfall. There we go. All right. So here's another shot, the waterfall shot. And zooming in at 100% here. Again, XT4 on the left, XT5 on the right. Bring these over. You see that resolution difference again. And just like the other image, it's really not a huge difference in terms of actual image quality aside from the resolution. Everything else looks pretty much identical. And next shot here, let's go ahead and look at these two shots. So this is XT4 on the left again, XT5 on the right. And let's zoom in. And you can see here this leaf, so much detail that's being pulled out really by both cameras, but you know, just even more from the X-T5. Now, as you can see here, there's some snow on this stick, and it was raining as well, so everything's pretty wet here. All these little this little moss. And you can see so much detail here. Got a little water drop there. But yeah, I mean, the X-T5 is really doing awesome, in my opinion. And this other shot here, so this is obviously a leaf. I put a light behind the leaf to kind of get that effect where you can kind of see everything. And yeah, you can even see the light back there. I did a really great job here, as you can see. Anyways, this is just a test shot, so I'm not gonna be too hard on myself about it. All right, but if you look here, so again, we have let's switch these. Okay, so now again, we have the X-T4 on the left, X-T5 on the right here. And same story, it's just a lot of detail in both shots here, but just that extra bit over here on the X-T5, just because you have that extra 14 megapixels of resolution. And everything is just looking great there. All right, well, I hope that was helpful for you guys. But anyways, that's it for now. I'll see you guys on the next video.